I think it's time now to first of all to activate the agreement. So we businessmen want to show actions and show that we are here to develop the relationship. It's not only a paper on table. It's no, it's acts, it's facts. We collectively think that we have the same mindsets. We're all from the Middle East. And Israel has great exposure in technology, investments in technology. The Middle East is booming in technology. I think collectively, with our experience in the region, in the Middle East, and investment and in technology, adding to it the advanced technology of Israel, we can achieve a great success when it comes to investing in startups, either in Israel or in the Middle East or even beyond.
I'll tell you that Israelis appreciate that mentality, that the business ties can be the start of real friendship and concrete ties between the countries. Now, that sounds like something that's motivating you as well, beyond the business interests.
Indeed. Any relation starts with business. It's a fact throughout history. People know each other by business. Trade created a good relationship between countries. Trade solved problems between countries. So I think we are ambassadors of peace as businessmen, and we're ambassadors of creating relations between nations. Through business, we build the backbone, if you can say, of any successful relationship, and we show that there is something on the ground that is developing, creating the bond between these nations.
Now, perhaps you can reveal that prior to the establishment of normalization, did you have ties with Israelis? Was there already some business dealings going on?
I had not with Israel, but I have a Jewish board member since 2014 in my company.
So I assume he had some influence over at least the access there. But let's shift to a different topic here and look at the bigger picture. We have an incoming U.S. administration likely to be take on a different tone than the previous one when it comes to world affairs here. But the Trump administration was so obviously key to developing the ties that are now benefiting in the business sector between you and Tel Aviv here. Do you think that's likely to continue, those relationships developing around the Middle East under the incoming administration?
I think our leadership in both countries, in Israel and the UAE, they are more focused on their relation, and they will build up their relation regardless what happens in the States. Either it's Democrats ruling or Republicans ruling, we are very mature, and we understand that there should be an end to what was happening. And once UAE, especially in the United Arab Emirates, we start an effort to build the relationship with the nation, we make sure that it reaches to a success. I think it's the best agreement was between both countries, Israel and the United Arab Emirates. Both countries are mature when it comes to systems, development, knowledge, and technology. Collectively, we can build a strong bind between the nations and even export whatever we are doing to other countries.
Now, any plans in the near future perhaps to open up shop in Tel Aviv or come visit, open an office or a chapter in Israel as well?
Oh, of course, indeed. We're just waiting for this pandemic to end up, and we'll be more than happy to be there. Visit as a tourist, first of all, then also establish our branch there.